Okay, this is another video on describing data. We've talked about that there are four things that we need to describe: the shape, the center and spread, and unusual features or outliers. And we're going to continue in this video with measures of spread. Then we'll talk about how shape and spread go together. If you need this worksheet, it's on my website at caroleemath.com. Let's talk about three different measures of spread. There's range, interquartile range, and standard deviation. So let's just talk about what each of these are. The range is the total width of the data. So it's the max minus the min. It's the total range or spread of the data. After we define these, we'll go through with our test score example and calculate that. The interquartile range is the width of the middle half of the data, the middle 50%. So this is the width of the middle 50% of the data. So we're kind of ignoring the top quarter and the bottom quarter, and we're doing the middle two quarters, middle 50%. Now, the standard deviation is another measure of spread, and this is, you can think of it as the average deviation from the mean. It's the average So it's on average how far away are values from the mean. Okay, now I mentioned in another video how the center and spread go together. So there are certain values, certain measures that we want to use at certain times. So the interquartile range is used with skewed data. And so you would talk about the median and the IQR in terms of center and spread. The standard deviation is used with symmetric data. And so if your data comes out symmetric, then you would talk about the mean and the standard deviation. So the order of those things is really important. So you do the shape first. Once you do your shape, then you see, okay, is it skewed? If it's skewed, then you will calculate the median and the IQR. If it's symmetric, then you'll calculate the mean and the standard deviation. Now, sometimes you might want to calculate all of them, especially you could compare. If it's close, you're not sure if it's symmetric or skewed, you might compare the median and the mean, like we did in the center video, to see if they're very close, then you would know that it's pretty close to symmetric. Or if they're far away, then you would know that it's skewed. Okay, so that's a little bit about the three measures. Now let's go ahead and calculate these with this example. So we're continuing the test scores. I've got them in order this time since we've already put them in order. And we're going to find our five-number summary. That is a lot of these numbers. So it's the minimum. It's the Q1, which I'll explain what that means. It's the median, Q3, and the maximum. And those are five. One, two, three, four, five. Once you find those five values, that is called your five-number summary. So let me show you how to do that. Now, we already found the median in the last video. Just going to double check it. Going in one each time. Yes, that's right, it was 74. So that's our median. The median breaks the data into two halves. half below the median, half above the median. Now that's our middle number. To find the quartiles, we want to find the median of the lower half and then the median of the upper half. So we'll skip the center and now we'll go, I'll underline. I don't know if there's going to be one in the middle or two in the middle. Okay, there's going to be one in the middle. If there were two numbers in the middle, we would average those two together. But there's only one, so this must be an odd number. There's only one. That is our Q1, or first quartile. What that means is a quarter of the data is below that value. A quarter is between Q1 and the median. We're going to find our upper quartile, or third quartile, here. This should also be an odd number. Yes, so 84 is our Q3. And then we can also write down, we've got our minimum, that's the smallest value. Our maximum is the largest value. So there is our five number summary right there. So we could list it out as 49, 62, 74, 84, 96. And then I like to put points, always put the units on there. That is our five number summary. That's going to be important. We're going to use that to make our box plot in a couple minutes. Okay, so that's our five number summary. Let's now calculate the range, which we talked about is the max minus the min. So we have our max and our min. It's going to be 96 minus 49. Let's see what that is. 47. So our range is 47 points. What that tells us is the total range of the scores that the students scored within 47 points away from each other, or 47 points was the total spread. That's quite a bit. It's almost half the test. Now the inner quartile range is like the range, but it's just between Q3 and Q1. So it's the width of this middle half. So that is Q3 minus Q1, which is 84 minus 62. points. Now it makes sense that it's less. The reason the IQR is really useful is that, let's say you had an outlier on the upper end or an outlier on the lower end or both, that would really affect the range. These 49s are affecting the range, but the middle 50% is a much more robust statistic. It's not going to be sensitive to outliers like the range is. So this is usually the more preferred statistic to use. That's why when it's skewed, we don't really use the range, we use the median and the IQR. It's helpful to know the range though. Okay, now we are going to make what's called a box plot. And the box plot uses these five numbers, the five number summary. And you'll see where the IQR is on there also. So just like when we made our histogram, we make a scale along the bottom. So let's see, we're starting with 40. 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100. Okay, so I could go there or I could shift at one, it doesn't matter. I'll just start at the left. 40, 50, 60, 70. I like to start with the median. It's in the middle. So 74, 75 would be here. So we're going to draw a vertical line. That's where the median is. We're going to be making a box. The other ends of the box are Q1 and Q3. So at 62, at 84, just below 85. So that's called the box part of the box plot. And you don't have to label these every time, but just for your notes, that's the median, that's Q1, that's Q3, and then we extend out. Sometimes it's called a box and whisker plot. We extend the whiskers to the min and the max. So our minimum was 49. So I'm going to draw a little line at 49 and attach the whisker to the box. And then the highest score was 96. So 95, 96. There we have, and usually you see this is one solid box with the median in the center. So that is our box plot. You can use box plots often to see if the data is symmetric or skewed. This one actually looks fairly symmetric, but we know that our data was a little skewed. So that's when you want to compare your mean and your median. They were kind of close to each other. 74 and I think 72 something, so fairly close to each other. And that's how you draw a box plot. So first you find your five number summary, and then you use those five numbers to draw. Let's label these min, max, and let's label that these are points, and that these are test scores. Okay, great. So there's just one more part to talk about in terms of our four things. Well, we haven't talked about the standard deviation yet. That's a longer calculation, so I'm going to save that for a different video. But in terms, we've talked about the four things in terms of shape, center, and spread, and now we need to talk about outliers. Are there any outliers in this data? So outliers are unusual or extreme values. It's kind of subjective sometimes, but there are some measures, some mathematical rules or formulas that you can use. We won't be doing any in 105, but we will be doing some if you take statistics later on, Math 243. So for right now, it's a little bit subjective. Does it seem like any values are extremely far away from the others? And let's go back to the data. 49 is not that far from 52. 58, it kind of goes up gradually. And then 86, 91, 96. I don't know if I would say the 96 is an outlier, although it is a little far away from the 91, but this all seems pretty reasonable. It doesn't seem excessively far away. So I'm going to say no. There are no outliers in this data. We can also tell from the histogram. Let's see if I can find my histogram here. Where did I put it? The histogram that we did for this data, notice we don't have any gaps. So that's another indication that there are not any outliers. If we had a big space and then there was a 22 down here or something, then that would definitely be an outlier. Okay. Down at the bottom, I just have a reminder which measures to use. So if the data is symmetric, we're going to use the mean and the standard deviation. And if the data is skewed, we're going to use the median and the IQR. Okay, so that's about measures of variation, and we'll talk about standard deviation in the next one. Okay, see you there.